Okay, so in this part, we will be just creating our facial hair. We will be creating beard and mustache and hair of our character. So, as I said before, I like to have some colors on our model. So, as you saw, I've made boots in this brown color. Our jeans are blue, of course. And now I'm starting just from a simple box. Our beard. And of course I'm using standard trick. I'm making a half of the beard and using instance and scaling this instance on negative X axis to have symmetry on these two pieces. We'll be just extruding this little box and trying to match his jaw. This is of course base mesh, so it will be really simple. After exporting it to ZBrush, we will add tons of details, but for now it's very simple. So I put this little geometry around his jaw, trying to pose it in the position where our beard will be, cleaning up faces inside because we don't need them. So it's just extruding polygons around his neck and jaw, so we will skip this a little bit further. And now you will see, you see that we have more geometry and our beard is almost done. I use sculpt geometry tool to smooth some geometry. Use of course soft selection to pose it, modify shapes. And of course, I will add some colors. But now a few tweaks. I said we don't need any geometry that is inside, so we can delete these polygons. So right now we will start making moustache. Of course, same technique, starting from a box, mirror the instance. Now we can work on both sides. So again, extruding, adding some edge loops to support geometry. Deleting polygons that are inside. So, same stuff as before. So a few changes to this mustache, and we will be starting making our hair. Of course, again, deleting polygons that are inside. I know it's boring, but we have to do this. Starting character is always a little bit boring. The most interesting part is in ZBrush, I think, where you have some freedom, you can add cool details, have fun with sculpting. So I think that's why people like doing characters, because they can play in ZBrush with geometry. Have a little bit Chuck Norris style beard. And we are starting right now. Hair just from a simple box as before. We will be extruding this little box along his skull and then closing existing holes, shaping it a little bit. And as I said, we will be extruding this along his skull, which is the fastest way of covering this part. Deleting, of course, polygons that are inside. And we will be trying to close this existing hole that is rest of the head. And that will be our base mesh. We will add later in ZBrush good details to the simple geometry. I hope next movie will be a little bit more interesting, because we will be taking all this stuff that we've got right now to ZBrush, and we will be starting sculpting some facial anatomy, posing some base meshes. As you will see, I didn't make a shirt yet, because we will add it later. After having face, hair, and almost rest of the body sculpted, we will sculpt hands before adding shirt. And after having all these parts on the place, I will add a base layer of the shirt, and then we will sculpt details on our shirt. So I didn't want to make it already, because we really don't have our body set up correctly, so it would be a problem while having our shirt. So we will finish sculpting our body, we will add our shirt, we will sculpt details on our shirt, and after that we will be not much to do, just we will add just some details like toolbag, gloves, and our character will be completed. Of course, only the model, because we will still have great polygons, I mean low poly mesh for this character, great UVs and make maps and start texturing. So we are extruding some edges, trying to cover this part of the skull, merging vertices. So after connecting this, we will skip a little bit further when we will have this hole closed. As you see right now, it's almost done. Yeah, in this case, we want to keep everything with quads. I didn't want to have any triangles. It's a good habit of having triangle, yeah, it's a good habit to not have triangles on your base mesh, but in some cases you don't have to worry about this really. So right now we will move to ZBrush and we will start doing some more interesting stuff. Some sculpting. Okay, so see you in next movie.